అరుదు తాళపాక అన్నమయ్య పదముడు.
నమస్తే, నాచారంబ వెల్కమ్స్ యూ టు తామ్రపత్ర కాన్వర్సేషన్స్ 7, అ మంత్లీ సిరీస్ దట్ ప్రీసీడ్స్ ఎవ్రీ మంత్ తామ్రపత్ర లెర్నింగ్ సెషన్స్ ఆన్ జూమ్. Brought to you by Nacharamba and presented to you by some of the most eminent dancers of the country. Tamrapatra Conversations brings to you all things Annamacharya, beautifully, exquisitely, and with great scholarship, hosted and anchored by renowned dancer scholar, Dr. Anita Ratnam, who speaks to the scholar, Dr. Anupama Kailash, to the dancer choreographer of the month, and to me, Ananda Shankar Jayant, the creator of Nacharamba and Tamrapatra. Welcome, Dr. Anita Ratnam, to Tamrapatra Conversation 7. Isn't it amazing that we're already on the 7th conversation?
I can't believe it. We were just talking, Ananda, it seems like just last week, about Tamrapatra itself as an idea. You know, and
it seems like yesterday.
It does. And I don't even know where 2021 has gone.
Right.
It's just gone by so fast. And very much like what you were saying, you finish one Tamrapatra session, it's already time for the next.
Time for the next.
But you have arrived at the halfway mark.
Yes.
And I have to say that it's a very judicious selection and arrangement of artists and content and the tone of every composition that Anupama has selected, that you have, you know, overseen. And it's really hard today to maintain interest in one topic throughout the year. And halfway through, I think people are as excited with this series as they were when it was first announced.
I think the credit is completely the choreographers, the 12 choreographers, minus me, of course, I'm one of them. So 11 choreographers who have brought their own individual knowledge, individual scholarship, and individual unique take on what they would bring to a choreography. And of course, Anupama, who kind of anchors the whole thing with her deep scholarship, her love, her continuing love with Venkateshwara and Annamacharya.
I'm telling you, she's chief PRO.
That's what you said in your amazing session. People are still remembering your session last month.
It was a lot of fun. It was challenging. And I know that every choreographer is trying to actually learn something while sharing, because I think that's the best part of it, you know, taking a composition that maybe most of us have not been very familiar with. And even though the name Annamacharya is so well known in South India and even amongst dancers, Ananda, so much of his work has been used in congregational and ritual use.
Yes.
You know, and dancers do dance it, but do they dance it consciously? Consciously knowing what a prolific and brilliant composer he was, the time that he lived, the kind of work he did, the kind of strands of thoughts and images and imagination he pulls together. It's mind-boggling, you know, mind-boggling.
Absolutely. So, and, you know, this time, you know, we went through Radha, we went through Andal with you. And prior to that, there were different moods and emotions. This time, Annamacharya takes us to the Sakhi. The leitmotif of all classical dance forms and all the Abhinaya aspects. We all have been a Sakhi, especially in Kalakshetra, how many times have we been Sakhis? Chavaram Sakhis, that's our entry to choreography, right?
And also, you know, it's really interesting because as the Sakhi, you have to almost mirror the heroine's emotion.
Yes.
You have to also anticipate what she's thinking. And you have to always be there. I mean, a shoulder to cry on, somebody to bounce off ideas with, also somebody to take her irritation and frustration out on.
And you're invariably younger than her on stage, but she's older, but you have to act mature. So that was quite interesting learning. You know, I have a very interesting anecdote about this whole Sakhi and the messaging idea of dance. You know, some years ago when I was performing in Music Academy, those days when, you know, when they had the earlier model, when they had once in 4 years, you had a cooling off period. It was, you know, so you had a whole evening to yourself, that kind of, you know, those days. So I was sending off, I was doing one Varnam, and I was sending off this kili from, you know, with a letter, of course. And the killi, in its typical way, would fly and would come back and sit on Vishal. So I would take the killi, tell her to go, and then the killi would come back and sit on the shoot. And finally, of course, I would send the letter through the Sakhi. So this was happening. So there was this lady I knew, and she came up to me and said, "Yettanama killi anpare, why can't you just send an SMS?" That was the early days of the mobile phone. I'm like, that's a brilliant idea. So now the Sakhi and the SMS, I think. I mean, but jokes apart, what are your takes on the Sakhi? I mean, how important is he or she?
You know, I think throughout dramatic literature, because Shakespeare uses it a lot, the heroine always has her best friend,
right,
you know, whom she's confiding in. And so the motive of that best girlfriend, the BFF, you know?
Yes, BFF.
has appeared through time in literature, because you always find that the heroine comes from a certain class, and
yes,
is more cloistered,
yes,
and lives in more of a bubble. So right, it is the Sakhi that is the sort of conduit between her and the real world.
Right,
the
Sakhi, absolutely,
is the one who's actually bringing the news about the real world. What's happening on the streets? What are people saying? What is the gossip? So because we have this sort of class structure, even not just in Indian literature, we have
everywhere.
Yeah, in so many other kinds of writing. I find that the Sakhi is actually a very interesting, very, very interesting character that we haven't explored enough. We tend to look at her as some kind of an add-on,
right,
you know, but we don't really invest her with the kind of experience. And, you know, she selects also what she has to tell the heroine.
Absolutely.
She must be having so much more information, but she will gauge her mood and maybe perk up her mood when she's feeling a bit down, or, you know, calm her down when she's way too exuberant. So here is, as you say, a wiser,
right,
and I would say more worldly right, individual, trying to almost lead this newbie, you know, this girl who just seems lost in love or whatever extreme emotion she has given herself up to. And here is this Sakhi, in a way, trying to be that reason, you know, trying to bring her.
But Anamacharya, in one of my Ekaharya, Shringara Darpanam, I had strung it together in the format of Gita Govindam, in which Sati goes to Venkateshwara and tells him, Upacharinchagarada, go and do some upacharam to her. She'll come back. I know she's very angry because you came very late, or you had some other, you know, images on you, and she got jealous. So she tells him, Upacharinchagarada, go and do this to her, go and comb her hair, go and fan her. So the Sakhi advises him also. So it's quite interesting to see how Anamacharya has placed the Sakhi, you know, and this time.
Yeah, and also, you know, that the Sakhi has direct access to the hero.
Yes, yes,
you know,
yes.
She doesn't have to go and tell his best friend.
Right. So, he just fall in love with the hero too. You know, that also could happen.
I know.
So on that, should I now call over, ask our request, our scholar, Dr. Anupama Kailash, to join?
Absolutely.
I think she's waiting. There you are, Anupama. Welcome to Tamrapatra Conversation 7.
Thank you, Akas.
So we were talking about Annamacharya and, you know the Sakhi, the Sankirtana that I have used in Shringara Darpanam, Anupama.
Yes.
Upacharinchagarada. So we were just saying, you know, the different kind of Sakhi. So, you know, Anita and I were chatting, and he said, this is the right time for you to come in. So what would you like to talk about some of the different types of Sakhis?
Yes, Akka. Actually, even in texts, we have an entire section called the Sahayaka sections. So amongst the Nayaka, Naika, the prototypes, and then we have the Sahayaka prototypes. In the Sahayakas, we have number of Sakhis. And what their duties are, well, I don't want to give it away here in the conversations, because I also want to save some of that for
of course.
our
for the workshop.
Session.
Right.
But basically, I think in most Shringara Bhakti literature, the Sakhi has acted as the alter ego of the Nayika in many ways, and also as the, you know, as the friend, guide, philosopher, and as the Acharya. Almost like a guru to her, because multi-dimensional Sakhis we find. And in Annamacharya, of course, we have Sakhis, you know, who coach the Nayika, who guide her, who prod her, who chastise her. So we have such a wide range of Nayikas in that. I think one song sums up what the Sakhi Bhava is in Annamacharya. When the Sakhi tells Alamelu Manga, she says, Sakalam he Sakhi Janami. She says, I know everything. I know everything that is inside Sakhi. You. She's a very dangerous Sakhi.
Dangerous Sakhi.
So she says, I know everything. And I think that's it. The Sakhi knows everything, basically.
It's very interesting, Anupama, because we have so much of women and women, you know, a woman's world, basically, the interior of a woman's world, physically within her bedchamber, within her dressing, the bathing area,
yes,
where the Sakhi is present, you know, dressing her, bathing her, sometimes at the end of the day, you know, taking her out of her expensive clothes, combing her hair and calming her down, getting her ready for bed. And we don't have enough love poetry of men and their sakhas.
Yes.
You know, but we do have some examples in early Tamil Sangam poetry,
yes,
where the hero is pining for the woman and he tells his friend, you know, we have a lot of modern pop songs, you know, and the ghazal and that format of, you know, lovelorn men.
Yes.
But it seems to be that the world of women is more interesting, more colorful, more layered for poetry.
Yes. Annamacharya has written several songs of Purusha Viraha also, of the male protagonist, where, in fact, I almost find them, you know, like the layering that you have in the ghazals. That kind of a layering you have in many of his songs where, you know, like, for example, in one song, he says, Nelata Basi Undalenu, I cannot stay without this woman. And then there are very sensitive descriptions. And as the friend and the Sakha idea, Annamacharya has used Rama actually quite a lot for that. So he speaks to Lakshmana, you know, in his Viraha, and he tells him, look, I think that is, you know, Sita's hair. And then Lakshmana has to keep telling him, no, you know, that's a peacock's plume. You were getting confused. So that kind of things. And there are some beautiful Purusha based songs, even of Annamacharya. But yes, in proportion, naturally, the female, you know, songs are much wider. In fact,
you remember, Anita, in Chudamani Pradhanam, you know, the Rama's Viraham, Rama's Viraham, where he picks up the jewelry given by Sita dropped, and, you know, and I still remember, you know, Janardhan and Sir, with that, you know, extraordinary Viraham. I think all of us used to weep in the audience. And Lakshmana used to answer with Naham Janami Ke Yure Naham Janami. So I mean, I think we negate the male Viraha, you know, just because they can't show it or they can't, or they don't cry, or maybe they don't.
And you know, Ananda and Anupama, I'm wondering why male dancers who keep, you know, why they don't explore male Viraha. I don't see enough male dancers in today's world exploring that in their repertoire.
Right.
You know, yes. they tend to want to do the Padavarnams, which have been written by men, but with a woman, you know, in mind. There's so much literature that is so suited for today's male dancer. Because love is so constant. I mean, pop songs are still being written, you know, by these groups about the woman that they miss. But this is really something, and I think one of the features that Tamrapatra has done is to throw up the kind of range of Annamacharya's, you know, compositions.
Yes.
Because this month we are featuring on the Sakhi, but he's written so much also about male longing.
In fact, we will be having that with Vaibhav Arekarji.
In the last session.
It's a complete Purusha Viraha song that we will be exploring there.
We have to wait 6 more months, Anupama.
I know. That's true.
Well, good things you have to wait.
But it, you know, it would be interesting to look at why. I mean, this is a possibility, right? Everybody's looking for new material all the time.
Yes.
And sometimes instead of having all these modern songs written,
right,
exactly,
you know, why not go to these celebrated composers and look at songs that haven't been
Thank you for saying this, Anita. Anupama and I have, you know, we've been on the telephone, we keep talking to each other. Why do people get bad poetry written almost in the same meter from Ganesha to Mangalam? And, you know, in the same kind of, you know, poetry without any lilt, without any mood.
Yes.
Why would you just not go and pick up some lovely, just read?
There is so much. There is so much out there.
You don't need to write
so much. Yeah. I mean, if somebody is really daring, you know, Tirumangai Aazhvar has written such amazing poetry where he's just lovesick for Krishna, you know, and all the madness that he had, that he just says, okay, I'm lovesick, I'm mad, I'm running around the streets, you know. So it exists. What I mean is beautiful poetry exists. And I really think that dancers must dig deeper and be a little more daring. But coming back to this beautiful composition, so Anupama, who is this Sakhi?
Vipralamba Shringara again, Anupama? Is that the essence, as always?
Yes, the premise is Vipralamba Shringara. So this is a Sakhi who goes to Lord Venkateshwara and tells him that, you know, she is just waiting and waiting and waiting for you to come. So eppudu vattuvo ani, when she's thinking, when will you come? And she's been waiting, and there are so many beautiful metaphors in this piece where, you know, she talks about the chakravaka birds and, you know, birds which cannot bear to be separate from each other, which cry out in the darkness. So there are all these beautiful metaphors, and she's trying to convince him and saying, you know, you have to come to her. And it's one of the first times actually in Tamrapatra we're doing a complete female Sakhi pleading to Venkateshwara.
She's always been a, you know, confident, almost either, a Sadhina Patika.
Either we've had a first person, you know, Naika, or we've had something like what Anita ji did last time, where, you know, she juxtaposed three characters there, and, you know, we had Annamacharya's voice. So this is a very typical, you know, Sakhi song where she goes and she recounts, because that Viraha Ashwasa is one of the functions of the Sakhi, where she has to try to, you know, mediate between the two and somehow unite them. She has to unite them. So that is the attempt in this song that she's doing.
The Sakhis are amazing. You know, I mean, they don't turn around and say, get a life, no, just move on. They don't do that. They really, you know, listen to her, take the story, go to the hero and kind of convince him. Amazing. Is this the time
I wonder if they have a life, Ananda. If
they really want it, that's what...
Yeah,
there are some very dangerous
Sakhis. Okay,
do they have men in their lives? Do they have time for them? Because the heroine is always in some kind of a fix that she has to unfix.
So there are some very dangerous Sakhis also, which he writes about, who actually go on the behalf of the Naika but have an affair with the hero themselves.
That's bad on both parts.
So there are many, there are songs like that where, you know, she goes and then she's telling him, she says, now, what do we tell her? I mean, when we go back, now you tell me what I'm supposed to tell her. So you have, you know, the naughty Sakhi also.
Should we now invite Satyanarayan Raju, our choreographer of the month? I think we should.
Namaste.
Namaskara Satya Garu. Welcome to Tamrapatra Conversation 7. Thank you so much for accepting at the very last minute to be the choreographer of the session 6 that's coming up. We are really excited to have you and looking forward to how you would interpret this beautiful Annamacharya. Over to you, Anita, for all the questions that we're all brimming with.
Anita,
I have always admired your Abhinaya.
Oh, thank you.
No, absolutely.
And you're one of, no, really, because you're one of the few dancers who have understood and you have taken the time to understand the lyric and the poetry. And I think you are in a very unique position now. You are a Telugu and you're looking at this amazing poet's work. Yeah. And you're, you know, playing... dancing in the feminine tense is not new to you, because a lot of the traditional repertoire has been written by men in the voice of women.
Yes.
But as a Sakhi, I mean, this time you're playing the Sakhi. I mean, it's not like you're playing the heroine or Draupadi or Sita or some of those. And this is a very interesting dimension, right? And I'm very curious to see what the Satyanarayana Raju that I know, who's always in command, very elegant, you know, your very measured approach to your art, which I've always urged younger dancers to watch carefully.
Thank you so much.
So tell me, Satya, what were your thoughts when you first received this? I know you came in late, but when you received this particular song, what was your immediate reaction to Anupama?
First of all, I'll thank all of Ananda and Anita ji and Anupama. And I was in shock when Ananda called me and asked me. Then first thing I asked him, do I really fit in this Tamara Patra?
Satya. let's get to the answer. False, modest, and just you're an amazing artist, Satya.
When I got this song, I was very happy. I love to play Sakhi role, you know. It's also, even though it's a sad that Alamelumanga is asking Sakhi to go and ask Srinivasa to, you know, go and ask when he's going to come. Like in this, she's Alamelumanga is looking forward to the Srinivasa to come. But as a male dancer, I feel very proud to depict the women character, because I have a lot of respect for the women characters, and I've played Draupadi and other Sita roles and all. It's very close to my heart. It's a very challenging, actually, to interpret it as a Sakhi. I feel as a Sakhi, I'm feeling, what if I fall in love with the Srinivasa?
We were just discussing that. We were just saying, Anupama was saying, the naughty Sakhi will fall in love with Venkateshwara.
I'm really naughty Sakhi, and I definitely go look at him and I'll definitely fall in love. You don't go there, you stay with me, I'll say, that's it. It's a very challenging, and I'm very happy to get this song, this very beautiful Kriti. And I've spoke to Anupama many times to get, even though I'm a Telugu speaking at home, I'm not literature, I've never read like meanings and all, but very very understanding meaning is there. I'm looking forward to, you know, do more and more choreography. How I as a Sakhi, I'll go and first of all, when she asked me to go for ask him to come, I say, oh my God, he's somewhere in seven hills, he's sitting there, and I have to go and wait for seven doors to open. How will I go and wait for him? And my one more, even though this is a sad song, I was telling Anupama Garu, I'll use little bit humor in this, saying,
which you're very good at, which you're brilliant at.
Already Sridevi Bhuvadevi is sitting here on his chest. They both see this Sakhi and say, are idente vachindi manavanni. And these two will come out, and I want to show that. You know, these two. How can this one is come here? Let's see this fellow.
I love the Telugu. Idente vachindi. I love it. It says everything.
This is Bangalore Telugu I'm talking.
No, super. Super, super.
It's like in Tamil, idennadi iva vandita nam balaka. I don't know. I asked Anupama ji, Garu, if I can use the humor, and also I asked Ananda Garu, humor. Yeah, this is what I'm looking forward.
Satya, you know, I've noticed, and I wanted to respond to this. Lots of male dancers, when they do female roles, you know, they become what I call hyper feminine. You know, they exaggerate in a way that is almost awkward.
Yeah.
So I'm very curious, you know, to see how you will interpret the Sakhi. But why do you think that happens? You know, why do you have to exaggerate and become hyper feminine? We as the audience, you know, the Indian mind is so intelligent, it understands immediately what you're trying to do.
Yes.
You don't have to unnecessarily create some kind of a walk.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, supposedly a feminine walk, or pick your hip out to suggest a curved hip. So actually, this a more a comment.
Yeah.
Who is this Sakhi for you? Is she a very bold woman, taking slightly because Alagala Vanga is missing her Srinivasa. Is she very bold? She said, I'll go. Or she said, okay, Ma, I'll go. Now you stop crying. What is the sakhi for you? What is the sakhi for you?
I'm taking this way. When she Alagala Vanga asked her to go, I say, yeah, and that's it. Only this for this one, your way. I mean, why are you worried for that? He'll definitely, anyway, he'll come to you. Why are you like, you know, sitting and crying? That is Saki's reaction. I'll just go like this and bring him. So what is there? You are so pretty and he'll definitely come to you. How can he refuse to come? In that way, I'm going as a Saki. With a lot of confidence and
don't bring
him. And this, yeah.
So it would be really interesting to see the way you walk, you know, the she knows that she's going to succeed in her mission.
Yeah, my walk and all, in my other repertory also, I don't show like as you said, other male dancers, they do all those things. I don't do all those things. Before I go to to go to Srinivasa, I asked Alagala Vanga, this is okay. I'm also very pretty, right? Can I go to bring him? This is what I say, okay? Then I just walk around, say this, you know, just like that. In my performances, I've done Panchali with Vijay Shri, a big theater artist. I was a Panchali and she was also Panchali. And in my Varnams also, I've done many female characters. Till today, I've never got even reviews also, like I'm very feminine and all those things. Always got, thank God, my gurus. I never did. But I don't know how to teach these boys. I've told many my male dancers, you become a character, don't become a woman there.
Absolutely.
Just to take inside the character and don't keep on character change like this.
Yeah, the turning. Turning and becoming, correct.
For me, if it is, I just step back here and I just step back. That's it.
I don't turn
and become this one. I don't turn and become Mira. This is what I've learned.
So really looking forward, Anita. What do you think, Anupama? Any you want to add some more insights?
I'm joining the session. That is for sure. You know, because I'm constantly, I'm interested to learn about how you can convey with the least amount of dramatic flair, and how can you convey with the least amount? And I think the digital medium, because we will have an opportunity. I hope, Satya. That the camera will be in a way where we can just see the nuances of your face. Sometimes in a live situation, you're very distant.
Yeah.
But I think that's where you will excel, you know.
Yeah.
Just a little shift of the body, just the tilt of your head.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, how you can denote these things.
Yeah, yeah. Then for me, again, when I'm teaching, it comes to teach. I don't teach hands five times right.
Absolutely.
Yes, absolutely.
Up and back. I just see the character. And just that's it. I ask when I teach my students also, I never teach the left planal, walk panama, pinaleva, go and that this thing and all. That's my personally.
And I think that has been the essence of Tamrapatra also, that we just open the minds. We're not teaching an item. We are just allowing you to create. Windows of ideas.
I can tell people if they're well equipped, they can use a lot of props. You know, they can use door frames and standing there. All those things we can use. You know, and every time she, even in the sadness also, she can be like to take some nice angavastram and wear it and just look forward to him.
Yes.
All those things we can take and like. I use a lot of props in my Abhinaya, I've used a lot of dupattas and peacock feathers and flower garland, everything I've used. People connect it. And I mean, they call me, I'm a very Lokadharmi dancer. I'm very happy to be called like that. I don't mind.
Dance has to communicate.
I think the whole understanding of Natya Dharmi and Lokadharmi itself is very skewed.
Just because you use a prop doesn't mean that you become Lokadharmi. You know?
And, I mean, look, imagine for the audience, I mean, for the those who register, they and I think last time, Anita,
and I don't think
props,
there's anything wrong with the word Lokadharmi. I mean, what is wrong with Lokadharmi?
I used props because...
I mean, last session, Anita used props so interestingly. Yeah, and next session, Satya's planning
I think
to, which
people
means...
just pick up the text once.
The idea.
What is the definition of Natyadharmi and Lokadharmi?
Correct.
I think they just need to understand that, because Natyadharmi is only that which is unrealistic, that's all. That which is not, in, you cannot do it. Like, for example, if you have two time zones which are showing simultaneously on stage, morning on the right side or night on the left side, this cannot happen in reality.
Correct.
That is called Natyadharmi. But anything that you that happens in reality, like a person's emotion, a conversation, anything, everything is Lokadharmi.
Correct.
Yes. It doesn't mean that if you take your hand in a stylized manner, then that is Natyadharmi.
No, when I did my Putana in my Sri Krishna Kamalanatha Varna, when I do Putana, I do full plastic surgery on the stage. Our bosoms will become very nice, very all. I make it nice structured, and I take out all her this thing and make her nose beautiful. And she herself will go, you know, this when she see herself. When I did this, people were really enjoying, and some people they came, yo, tumba natya dharmi agoitu, you know, loka dharmi agoitu. I said,
so
okay,
the person who is
enjoyed, I am happy, you know.
We need to change.
I think we should not bother about missing. You should just stay, you know, stay true to your own path and your own way of doing things. You know?
Especially today, Ananda, we keep saying that classical dance is not reaching people, it's not accessible.
Exactly.
We're keeping a text, we're interpreting it in a way that is holding people's attention and making it accessible. So it piques their interest.
And finally, I think what needs to really, are the audience getting what you're trying to convey? Yeah. Are they getting the story? Now, if you're going to use it stylistically, that's fine. If you want to do it in a very different way, that's fine. Finally, who's going to be the judge? The audience. Are they taking away something from the story? I think
everything begins and ends there.
So this is really amazing, you know, we're the first here, Satya Narayan Raju is our first male choreographer in the we've had five women dancers and choreographers, and this is the first, I mean it's the sixth and the 12th, two male dancers. So it's very interesting. And Anupama, Anita, you want to add something more? Or
I'm really looking forward to this, Satya, because I think it's going to be learning as well, you know. As because so much about our classical arts is the power of suggestion.
Yes.
You know, the power of suggestion. And how do you know the text? Yes. The audience doesn't know the text.
Exactly.
They know something of maybe, but how do you draw them in with your style? You know, for me.
And also sometimes the text also can be a big filter. It's a big filter because someone doesn't understand the language, or someone is too caught up in the language, or too caught up in the music. I mean, so many, you know, ifs and buts can happen.
So communication
is that much, you know.
Yeah.
How you communicate is fine.
And watching a mature artist for me is always a delight, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
Somebody who spent years and years on the stage, in the craft, in the art, you know. So for me, the older one gets, the more interesting the artist becomes.
It's vintage.
You know, Satya, what we should do, you and I should do our Rama, you do Ramakatha, I'll do Tyagaraja Ramayanam, and you do your, Anita, you do your, your Vrindavana Saranga.
Yes, absolutely.
I think we should do an event like that.
Yes.
Because this is the time, you know, this is the time where that the world has changed.
Yeah.
Tamrapatra is an example of how to harness the conditions of the world and to use the technology and how to reach out with beautiful
content. How to share, finally, at the end of the day, how we can all share what we know with the next generation, with our own colleagues, with our own friends, how we can share and how we can bring content that is available. It's readily available. All we need to do is, you know, just all of us get together, hold hands, like, you know, across the net, and that's it. That's what we're supposed to do as a team, right?
Yeah, I'm very excited. Ananda, Anupama,
I'm totally excited.
So much.
I think I'm very excited about this session also, because, you know, first of all, I'm I will be talking about something which we haven't really discussed so far in all the other five sessions.
Looking forward to that.
The Sakhi idea. And then also, I've always admired Satyaji's Abhinaya, like Anita Akka said, because I think male dancers, as you said, Akka, they tend to use the body constantly.
Right.
I've always felt that Satyagaru uses his eyes.
Yes.
And that beauty of, you know, that the way he uses his eyes, the steadiness, I'm just looking forward to watching, you know, that kind of a delineation. So, yes, I'm absolutely looking forward to this.
And I, as producer, Natyaramba, I'm real, of Tamrapatra, Natyaramba's producer, I'm really, really excited and looking forward. Yes, Anita, you're saying something, sorry.
And knowing Satya's love of fabric and drapes.
Yes. Now we all have to get ready.
Yes. Looking forward to what he's going to choose, the drapes, the colors, the texture. So in so many ways, we are looking forward to it, Satya. Yes. Really, thank you for this. And really,
by all of you, all great scholars like you all, I'm inspired, that's it, you know. Always watched you all perform and your ideas and your artistic things, always inspired. Thank you. Looking forward.
We will inspire each other. That's really important.
Thank you so much, Satyanarayan Rajagaru, Anupama Kailash, Anita Ratnam, for being part of Tamrapatra Conversation 7. Anita, as usual, you anchor it, and you kind of you kind of bring so many dimensions, and of course Anupama too. And we are looking forward. I hope you all enjoyed this session, Tamrapatra Conversation 7. Registrations are open for Satyanarayan Raju's Tamrapatra Session 6, which is on the 11th and 12th of December, same time, 7:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time. Registrations are almost getting there, almost get closing. So hurry up, register, and learn, and look, I'm looking forward to learning so much from. I'm going to bring a big pad and pencil for Anupama's different exquisite expositions of the Sakhi, which we haven't discussed yet, and Satyanarayan Raju's exquisite, as Anita beautifully put it, measured, deep, beautiful Abhinaya that we're all going to get a peep into. So quickly go out there and register for Tamrapatra Session 6 at tamrapatra.mystrikingly.com. So thank you very much, Anita, Anupama, Satyanarayan Raju, for being part of Tamrapatra
Conversation.
Thank you, Akka. Namaste.
I'll see you soon at the next session.
Yes.
Thank you.